Let's get an attribute from an AF element and put that on a trend. Now I say put it on trend just because that's what I happen to be working with, but I could put it on any web part. So let me demonstrate. I'll go into modify this web part. I'll choose the tag search. You know I should stop calling that the tag search. It's not labeled the tag search anymore. Now it's called select PI data. And that's for a reason. See, it's not an accident that the first tab that shows up is the attribute search. We are moving towards a more AF-centered, more element-centered view of PI data. Yeah, that's not an accident that this comes up first. And what I'm going to do, in addition to trending my PI tag, I'm going to look at the structure within AF here, pick out the Houston office. I'm drilling down here through the elements in AF to chemicals, and I should be able to find an equipment list with some flow meters on it. And I'll just choose the first area there. Yeah, notice this has an option here called the flow rate. That's an element attribute. The element is this right here, and this is the attribute. I'm going to go ahead and choose that attribute. I think I'd like to also choose a tank. Here we go. Now there's two things that we're going to be putting into the web part when we click on OK. We're going to be putting the name of this attribute, but we're also going to put the context in which that attribute was found. The context is essentially this big long structure that we see right here. If you look down here, you can see it as it's basically everything. I can't highlight this properly, but everything on there except the very last part. Oh, there we go. Yeah, everything on there except the flow rate and the concentration. That's the context. So when I click on OK, you'll see that we have placed in here two things. That's the attribute name, and that's an attribute name that doesn't need to be unique. And in fact, it's nice if it's not unique, because then you can change the context, and when you change the context, you'll see different data appear in your trend. Now, so when we map this flow rate with this context path, and I can't really see it here, but if we look all the way over to the end, yeah, you can see this is that section on flow meters. If we look at concentration, that's the name of the attribute, but if we go all the way over in the context, you can see this is coming from that tank. So it's the two of these together, the name of the attribute and then the context of that attribute, that allow us to figure out which PI tag is associated with that as a data reference. And then that's of course what we trend. Now you can trend other things instead of just data references to PI tags. If you have a data reference that points to a constant, or actually that wouldn't be a data reference, but if you have a constant, that's something that you can trend as well. And one more thing about the data reference that you make here, the AF attribute that you're going to be referencing here, that has to be a data reference to a PI tag, but it has to be a data reference that hasn't had a modification to this section right here called the value retrieval methods. It's a restriction on what we can currently trend. So if you have a data reference like these are all data references in AF. If the value retrieval method has been modified, then that's something that will not currently be able to be trended in PI WebParts. I'd like to go back and point out one more thing that may help explain something we saw earlier in class. If you recall, when we described this section over here, the attribute context path, there was this little lightning bolt that indicated connections. This is where you would make a connection to some kind of a web part that would pass to this web part the path that's appropriate. So one of the things you can configure is with the PI tree view, you can configure it so that it passes a path, you know, its current path over here, which means that as you change, you know, from one node on that AF tree to another in the tree view, you'll see different PI trends appear on here. You know, depending on, as I said, it's the two things that we look for to resolve the actual tag name that we're going to trend. It's the name of the attribute and the path that we're using right here. And with a connection, you can make that path change as you change your PI tree view. And actually, the section called Build Element Relative Web Part Pages in the video coming up is going to be a demonstration of exactly that feature.